Everybody, and welcome once again to the Domino Theory television program. My name is Gil Francis and I will be your host. We would like to welcome you to this program, which is broadcast on channel 29 and 76 here in San Francisco, California, and under the auspices, of course, of the Bay Area Video Coalition, which we refer to fondly as BAVAC. Today is what? July the, I guess somewhere around the 15th. We tape these things in advance, but anyway. We've just had the July the 4th holiday, and we have people that are out on summer vacation, and I'm sure that all the young people are very grateful for that. I always was when I went to school, of course. I want to say thank you to all the people that put together the tech forum that was held at one of the City College satellites out on 3rd Street 2 weekends ago. Very successful. I'm sorry, it wasn't on the weekend, it was on the weekday. It was on a Tuesday, as a matter of fact, yeah. But anyway, we had a good turnout. Some people came in from some of the startups from downtown and talk to young people about advancing their careers and educations in the tech industry. We here in San Francisco have Google, Twitter, well, you name it, we got it, because this, of course, is in close proximity to Silicon Valley. And we urge you young people to take advantage of some of these programs that are available to you. We have programs here at BAVAC that are available to you also, and a lot of these things are at no cost or minimal cost, so you might want to look into it before the summer's over. Also, I think there are some internships available through the city of San Francisco, which I'm sure there would be considering. Anyway, I want to thank those people. Just observing what's happening around the country in politics, and I don't want to get into this thing with the, you know, the new guy, but it just seems to be a mess that's compounding itself. It's just getting worse and worse, and all I ever hear, like on the news now, is that, and it's just getting to be just kind of weird. So I hope it all straightens itself out, and I hope that we will all pray for the country, whoever all that includes. So if you're a praying person, now is the time to start doing it, for sure. I want to congratulate the ladies in Congress, because they, what was it, no arms? There's an archaic law that was on the congressional books that said that lady Congress people or anybody in that chamber, pardon me, had to wear long sleeves. Now, why that has been on the books this long and nobody said anything about it, I have no idea. But now, I think mainly because there are so many more women that are in Congress now. That, of course, had a lot to do with this being enacted. But anyway, the way that these people, these ladies got together, and it's going to happen. So now they can wear short sleeves, which is really good. I also want to give kudos out to the ladies in Oakland who recently had the demonstration. There weren't a lot of ladies of color that participated back in January in the demonstration. But yesterday, I think this weekend's demonstration made up somewhat for that. However, we still need to homogenize and all get ourselves together and do it on the same day, same time, same channel, that kind of thing. So once we are on the same page, I think it'll all be a lot more effective. We have a website, which is at www.sfdominoclub. And, I'm sorry, www.sfdominoclub.net. There's confusion in here. But anyway, if you go to www.sfdominoclub.net, you see some of the videos that we put up. We are in the process of refurbishing our website, and we hope that you will give us a chance to do so. I've been busy with a lot of things lately, but it'll all be okay. Everything will be okay. I have some things to show you. I got some music for you. I also have some things I want to talk to you about, midnight basketball, and some other clips. So, with that said, I'll be back. Thank you.
give it up.
Okay, we're here at the Fillmore Mini Park, and this is one of my old-time acquaintances, Mr. Ronnie Cole, who is also an artist. And he has put together here in the Fillmore Mini Park some very interesting designs, and he's used. Okay.
All right, go ahead. So now, 1337 Fillmore in the San Francisco 8, a member of the Panther, that the building was shot up right here on Fillmore. Over here is a dream catcher that I started earlier, and I needed it because this whole section of fence is my large dream catcher on 40 feet of fence.
Uh-huh. So you use the fence as a canvas?
The fence is my canvas.
Uh-huh.
I come out here and do on-site installation, painting, drawing, design,
uh-huh,
all the way through. And I'm fascinated with three-dimensional stuff. And I learned this in Oklahoma. And they have an installation that's on at the Young Museum right now. It's the Revelations of the African-American Art of the South.
Uh-huh.
It's out there, and you can get a broader sense of the type of stuff I picked up when I went into the South, when I lived in Mississippi, when I lived in Oklahoma, Tulsa, Oklahoma, Dale City, Oklahoma. And this is the largest sense of me. This is a guy that's in this park constantly, and I did a character on site of him. This is an earlier painting. This is really my symbolic interpretation of Bookman. Bookman was the revolutionary that brought Toussaint L'Ouverture and others up in the mountains and told them to forsake their white gods, and their revolution started. They fought Britain, they fought America on the seven seas of this world. And this shrine that we built here is of West Coast Harlem. I'm still working on it. And then over here, I sort of Africanized the stuff that I'm working with. And if you look at the tiger, it's titled The Signifying Monkey. Now it's on you to find the monkey. And this is in tribute to Africa. This is our mini park, Africa. This is in remembrance of the fallen soldiers. And this is when the Pharaoh listens to the counsel of the elder. And then the child, there's three figures in there. There's more, but those are the central. She's reading a book about the history, the story, Alki Bulan, Africa, the diaspora. Everywhere we went, we built our own communities. We were locked in to Fillmore. If we went past Van Ness, we would get lynched. So this is it. And this is how we got here in the middle, in the great migration out of the South, through labor, through old technology. But today we are far removed from that because all of the stuff you see on that wall over there, on that fence there, is all about how we are involved in what is called planned obsolescence. If it's not planned obsolescence, then the other part is that it is upgraded and updated. And this is all the stuff that you see that has been updated and upgraded. From simple things like that.
Okay, can you tell us one more time who are the sponsors who are sponsoring you with this project?
Raw for Life, Brothers for Change, NCLF, the Domino Club, and the community at large.
We thank everybody that you just mentioned, and you for sure, and this young man, Mr. Joe DeRosta,
for allowing us to do it.
McHenry, thank you, sir.
Appreciate you, Sonny.
You guys take care.
All right.
Fillmore Street, Mini Park. Now, you guys also play dominoes over here?
Yes. Uh-huh. As you can see, this is the domino box that you had gave.
Uh-huh.
And when you gave it, we had to set up a domino space. So this space is going to be for the dominoes. And someone, another artist came and wanted to make this, and it fit it for the dominoes. So you can keep the dominoes, the domino stuff, whatever you need, and put it in there if you want.
Oh, okay. A good idea. All right. Appreciate that. All right. So now, what are you said you're going to expand this project? So you're going to do some more of this artwork throughout the Fillmore neighborhood, or is that still in the planning stages?
Yes. Well, if you look over here, it's Fillmore art.
Uh huh.
This is art from Fillmore.
Uh huh.
It just looked like junk.
Uh huh.
But that represents somebody talking on the phone.
Oh, is that right?
And coming out the drive-thru.
Oh.
And the phone flew out, and the hubcap flew off. So we thought we'd put it up and remember it. So if they ever see it, they remember it. They both was wrong.
Okay, so if that's your hubcap, you can always reclaim it by coming back out here to the Fillmore Street.
Gold award. He's ready to go.
Fantastic. Okay, we want to thank you very much, Mr. McHenry, for this interview. And we're going to submit this to the station so that we can put it up on their Facebook channel. And we wish you guys the most of success. I took pictures, and we're going to display those pictures along with this interview. Thank you very much.
All right, thank you.
Take care and God bless. Okay, today we are at the laundry, which is located in the Mission District here in San Francisco. And we're in the midst of an art show, which is featuring several very talented local people.
In front of me is Miss Lee, and I'm going to let her pronounce it because I don't want to mess it up.
Lee Westerlund.
Now, did you get that? Anyway, this young lady's from Sweden, and she's a very beautiful young lady that you can see, and very talented. She has, she wears many hats, one of which is photographer, and if you take a look at, that's my favorite. She does underwater filming, which this is totally fascinating for me because I have trouble doing filming above water. But these are really fantastic pictures. So we're gonna try to delve into what motivated this young lady to become some of the things that she is a part of. And one of the things that really fascinates me is the fact that she's a scuba diver. I am afraid to go into 6 feet deep water. I don't know if that's a valid admission or not, but I think that is just fascinating. Hi, Lee, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Good. Can you, where do you want to start?
We'd like to start with scuba diving, since that is a big part of what I'm doing. I started scuba diving in 95, actually, so I've done it for a long time. And I started in super cold water, 35 Fahrenheit. So,
why? Why did you start doing this?
I have always wanted to scuba dive. I have always wanted to go underwater. It's always fascinated me. I think that when I was really little, I saw Cousteau, and I saw, the few channels we had. We had like two channels, and I could see this underwater world that is absolutely mesmerizing to me. And
I think these pictures are really fascinating. So you traveled to which place most recently to do these photographs?
So when I do the macro, which is what is behind me, what I'm showing here, Indonesia is my favorite. It's still untouched. There's so much to discover. There are places there you can only get there if you live on these boats that are specializing in people who only want to scuba dive on their vacation time.
I understand.
Or job time, so yeah. But I love sharks and mantas, and I have some of my favorite places in Cocos Island, Socorro, and all these places. Malpelo is a rock 36 hours off the coast of Panama, in Colombia. And sharks is my biggest fascination.
So I can imagine this all keeps you very, very, very busy.
Yes.
And also one of the hats that Lee wears is that of a doctor, not a medical doctor, but can you expand on that a little bit?
Yeah, so I also have a day job, so I'm an attorney. And I didn't stop with just doing law school, I did a master. I went out and did clerkship for the judge. And then I went back in and did a doctoral in law, in biotech patent law. And that's actually what took me to the U.S. the first time around. So in 2000, I came to Washington, D.C. I was supposed to stay for 6 months. And it turned into 3.5 years. And then I went back to Europe for a little while. But then I came back in 2007 to D.C. And then I moved over here, went over 6 years ago now.
Uh-huh.
And California, I'm just saying, California is the place to be. Northern California is phenomenal.
That's incredible. I'm glad you're enjoying yourself. I have been here myself since 1957, and I think San Francisco is the bomb, as we said. Anyway, your exhibit is going to be here for the next 30 days, I understand?
That is so true, yes.
And how can people look at some of the stuff that you've photographs if they want to go on the internet?
They can go on lifethrills.com. So the word lifethrills.com. And Facebook, I have Life Thrills Photography. And also on Instagram. So you can reach me there.
Okay. So did we miss anything? What else? Is there anything else do you do besides the doctor and the scuba diving and the... And I'm not trying to overload you, but...
I do a lot of yoga.
Okay.
Bikram yoga, the hot yoga, and that's a lifesaver for me in all the business. Like, I can go to my yoga place, and I can ignore everything, and I can just stay with me and relax. So that's my... That's actually my relaxation.
Okay. Well, I just want to thank you very much for the interview. I hope you success, and I'm sure you will. What's your next scuba diving adventure going to be?
It's going to be either Cook's Island with the sharks again or Indonesia. And right now, I'm kind of going back and forth. But I've been on three trips now with sharks and more sharks. So it may be that I'll do the Indonesia one when I go with the macro, small stuff, curious stuff.
Well, good luck on that one. We certainly appreciate you, and God bless you.
Thank you.
Okay, I hope you're enjoying the show so far. This is, of course, the Domino Theory television program, and we're brought to you on the Cable Access Channel here in San Francisco on a semi-regular basis. Just a lot of stuff been going on, but anyway, we continue to move on. We hope that you enjoy our shows, and if you have any ideas or any questions or any comments, you can go to the website at www.sfdominoclub.net. That's all one word, sfdominoclub.net. And you can leave us a suggestion, or you can contact us at www.sfdominoclub.com. Why do I keep saying that? It's at gmail.com. I'm sorry. You gotta put the gmail in there, then .com. I'll get it together one of these days. Anyway, my name's Gil Francis. Hope you enjoy yourself. We'll be back. Ladies and gentlemen, we are here today, June the 2nd, 2017, in the Mission District, and our guest is Mr. James Below. Mr. Below happens also to be a professor. Well, not happens just to be a professor. He worked at it, but he is a childhood friend of mine. I never thought I'd see him this day, but I'm so glad to see him, and I'm so glad to see his works. And he's going to tell us something about some of the pictures that he's taken, some of the artwork that he brought back from Africa and other places. So here's Dr. James Below. How are you, James?
Fine, how are you?
Good.
It's so good to be here. But before I begin anything, I need to acknowledge the fact that this is probably one of the greatest days I've had in recent memory, being here with Sonny, who is a childhood friend, and to have an opportunity for him to be a guest with me and looking at the second exhibition that I've done in the San Francisco Bay Area. The pictures you see here before me are pictures that I've taken internationally, extending from countries like Africa, Brazil, China, Hong Kong, the Caribbean, just across a wide diaspora of our universe. And so I'm very happy to be here today to be featuring some of the pictures that we have been able to cast for you. As I said, these pictures are taken over a long period of time. For example, this is a collage of pictures that from New Zealand, India, Machu Picchu, Canada, India, Hawaiian Islands, Hong Kong, and of course the famous Grand Canyon. This particular demonstration of pictures here is a collage because I want everyone to see the range of the work that we've been able to do. I think it's also important to point out that this work that we're talking about also supports both the Project WET and the International American Foundation, which is designed to bring fresh water to people around the world, as well as to give people in the Caribbean. Caribbean and in South America an opportunity to find jobs. So there is a philanthropic, I would say there's a philanthropic notion behind this photography. So if I can move you a little bit over to this side, this picture here is a picture of what we call the line. This is taken in the San Diego Zoo, which happens to be one of the largest zoos in the world, as well as one of the most famous zoos in the world. We move right here to the right. These pictures were taken on the Masai Mara in Kenya, whereby we see this picture here is called Humanity. And the reason we call it is because, as you can see, there is a concern here, a giving and a sharing. And this is in a hut on the Masai Mara among the Masai tribe. This picture here is a picture of a Masai chief. And this picture here, over to my left, is a picture of women who are transporting goods. And if you can notice, it's on top of their heads. But this is how it's done over in that part of the country. And of course, over here, we have what we call the San Francisco Bay at dawn. This picture gives you an idea of taking you from the Oakland side of the Bay Bridge all the way to the beginning of the city of San Francisco and then into infinity. So it gives you a range of work that I have been able to do over the last, 10 to 15 years. It is a golden opportunity to come out of a little town in Patterson, Louisiana, and then coming into the world of photography. It is certainly something I've enjoyed doing. My first profession is the superintendent president of Hartnell Community College, where I retired from that, and now making photography one of my next ventures. So I hope that you visit me on hellophotography.com, where you have an opportunity to see the range of pictures. The young lady that just walked in, I want to introduce her to you. It's my very good friend and curator, Lisa Brewer. And Lisa can tell you more about the photography of Hello Photography.
Absolutely. Dr. Plow is an award-winning landscape photographer and cultural photographer. He is one of the best by far that I've worked with in my 35-year career. All of his original and limited edition prints are available in multiple sizes, different framing options. Shipping is free. So please come down and see us.
Thank you.
Okay, before I leave, I would like to say that Mr. Larry Gray, a good friend of mine, is the founder, one of the co-founders of the original Midnight Basketball Program. And we did that here in San Francisco for a while, but there was quite a bit of dissension in the ranks, and it sort of got misguided. But anyway, Mr. Gray is still pushing to expand the Midnight Basketball League beyond San Francisco, and we hope that sometime in the near future we'll be able to give you a link to his website and let you know how to contact him and get involved in the Midnight Basketball League. Midnight Basketball is not played at midnight. It's played in the evenings, and the young people that participate are required to participate in workshops before they play basketball. And the younger people play first so that they can go home and get some rest for school the next day, and the older kids play later. Sometimes those games go until about, I guess, about 11 o'clock or whatever, but it keeps those young people off the streets, and it keeps them busy and burns up a lot of energy for sure. And we will be broadcasting those if at all possible. The other thing is I want to show you a brief interview I did with a friend of mine I've been knowing for a long time, Dr. James Ballou from Patterson, Louisiana. And Dr. Ballou is, among other things, a photographer. And I would like to show you a brief interview we did with him recently in San Francisco's Mission District at a place called The Laundry. And The Laundry is not really a laundry, but it's a pretty clean place. Good place to have fun. Mission in South Venice and 24th, I think, something like that. But nice place, really nice place. Anyway, I want to show you some of Dr. Ballou's photographs, and then we will see you the next time. God bless you, and I hope that you will be safe until that time. And you can also go to our YouTube channel, you can go to our Facebook channel, and you can go to our website. Thank you very much once again. Take care. I can't wait to see another day.
translates no matter what. We're all just trying to find a way to live in peace, except for a few assholes along the way. So, there it is.
Yeah. Thank you.